Okay, so right now I'm using Kingsoft spreadsheet, and I want to show you a neat, cool feature that I like to use, especially when you're recording your data. So I'm just going to generically make up something. All on cap. I was gonna put bankruptcy, but nah, forget it. I put bank statement. Okay, so let's see, date, deposit. Okay, so this is like bank statements and so forth. So I put bank statements, the date, deposit, withdrawal, balance, and reason. So let me make this a little bigger. Size it up here, make it a size 18. Okay, bank statement. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and copy and paste this. Let's see, cut. Let me paste this right here. Okay. So basically, I'm just going to record all my dates that I deposit money, withdraw money, record my balance, and the reason why I withdrew my money. In order for you to do this successfully, you're going to have to freeze this here, so that when you scroll, you don't scroll the whole bank statement title with the dates, deposits, withdrawals, and so forth. So in order for us to do that, we're just gonna click here and go to view, go to freeze, and when you go to freeze, you're gonna see that a line crosses underneath your date, deposit, withdrawal, and so forth. That's very important because if your data is full and you need to go to line 50, you can just simply scroll down to line 50. And basically, when you get there, you're gonna know what date it says this is for, how much you deposited, what you withdrew, and so forth. If this line wasn't here and you didn't freeze this section, then every time you scroll for new data, you're gonna remove this. It's gonna scroll with it. You're not gonna know where your date most likely is, deposits with all, you know, I know I wouldn't. So this makes it a lot easier. You can scroll up and down, and this will stay the same. So, as an example, let's just say today's date, and I deposited $50 to my account, and so forth. I have a balance now of $100, whatever. But then on 7, 28, 15, I withdrew 25. Oh, no, wrong box. I withdrew 25. And now I have a balance of 50 again, right? No, 75. I can't even add, because I deposited $50, my balance is 100, I'm subtracting 25, and it gives me 75. And the reason I'm doing that is for food, groceries, whatever, however you want to write it. Just giving you an example. So eventually your data is going to fill up and you're going to want to scroll down to see where you're at. And so if you scroll, you see how it disappears. And that's pretty cool because if you unfreeze it, notice what happens. See, you're gonna lose out all your data. So the freezing part is pretty cool. Just keep in mind that no matter where you click, if you click under something, that's where the line is going to develop. See? So the best thing to do if you're gonna unfreeze that, make a line underneath the date, deposit, withdraw. Just click underneath it, hit the freeze button, and then it'll freeze it. All right, so that's a pretty cool feature that I like to use when it comes to my spreadsheets, and I thought maybe I'll share that information with you. I'm Alex Figueroa. Until my next tutorial, see ya.